Why are you mentioning films I've never heard about?
This is what happens, na. I tell you, you don't remember that I've said, you don't listen, and then 2-3 years later you remember that I told you. AK versus AK thing is honestly, creatively, was the scariest experience of my life. The
stuff that we've done. Not your film, it's my film.
That we've done, yeah.
What about Welcome?
No.
Come on, yeah.
I don't know.
Film, yeah. Majnu bhai.
Not my jam.
Everyone's talking about the, you know, about the trailer, and you know, it's been positive, and not because, you know, we are in it or something, but it's generally positive. Pata toh chalta hai, you come to know it is positive and all. So talking about the aesthetics, the look, the landscape, and about the nature of the Thar trailer. What is your reaction to feedback you got from your friends and your friends? What did they feel about the trailer?
I can't believe it. You kind of imagine making something or doing something, and you're so kind of involved in the process that you're not even really thinking about the outcome or what people will say or think. But then when you actually kind of put something out there that you've kind of helped create in a way, and people are so generous and optimistic, it gives you a lot of courage. Mm-hmm. You know, it gives you a lot of energy and self-belief, and you feel like all of the fights and the, you know, a little bit of the stubbornness or the strong-headedness is kind of validated in a way. So it's good.
And how do you deal with criticism when people criticize you?
So I think that there's all sorts of criticism, right? So there's some criticism that's coming from a very educated place and it's constructive. So I think you have to, and then there's some criticism that's coming from a little bit of a, Where kind of the person has an ulterior motive, or they're trying to project something onto you and just bring you down for the sake of it. So I think you need to have the intelligence, and you know, you need to be able to perceive and make your own mind up about, and trust your instincts about who you should take seriously and who not to.
Usually it would be direction, or that wouldn't have surprised me, or you know, you want to be an actor. I would be a bit surprised, because as a kid I never knew that, you know, that was there.
Yeah.
And then suddenly you said, I want to learn writing.
So in 11th and 12th, mm-hmm. In high school, I was very good at English creative writing.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously so kind of inspired by films and cinema and stuff. So always kind of just had the natural instinct to kind of write what I visualized. And everybody at some point in your life you meet and they're like, I have an idea for a film, you know. But I really wanted to understand what the process was and how a writer actually goes about taking an idea and kind of breaking it down into a story, and then a three-act structure and scene outlines, and what is the process of actually writing a script.
Mm-hmm.
So in at Chapman, actually, we had a class which was basically called Screen Acting for Writing Majors.
Mm-hmm.
So they would take all the writing students and make them do a full-on acting class, mm-hmm. for 6 months.
Okay.
So we had a great coach from New York who did a lot of theatre. His name was Tony Spiridakis.
Uh-huh.
And I did 6 months with him.
Uh-huh.
And we did a scene from A Fish Called Wanda.
Yeah, of course. One of my favourite films. Yeah.
A Fish Called Wanda.
Okay.
So I don't remember exactly what the scene was, but there's something about a secretary and a guy that's having an affair.
Yeah.
And so kind of opened me up a lot in that, and kind of, it was comedy.
Yeah.
So I kind of just felt like it was something I enjoyed doing. I just kind of felt like it was a great way to start the journey into the movies.
Okay.
And this is a good one. If you could redo an old Indian film with a new director, who would you pick and why?
Me?
Yeah.
Old Indian film.
So if there was a classic, 70s, 80s, 90s even, 60s, but and you had to do a remake, what would be the subject, and who would be the director?
Films like Kagaj Ke Phool.
Okay.
Okay, which was a Guru Dutt's film. And the director, Bansali, to direct it.
Okay.
Sanjay Leela Bansali. I just love his work.
Okay.
Then I would love, you know, Dad was involved. My dad,
yeah.
Your grandfather.
Yeah.
Was involved as an assistant director in Mughal-e-Azam.
Okay.
So that's the film which a lot of people wanting to remake, but I think it's very, really difficult.
Sometimes you should leave it alone.
Leave it alone.
Leave it alone, right.
There are so many films which I feel, I think they should not be touched.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, exactly. You know, because it has that, unless you have a very, very young perspective and a younger director who will make it more progressively.
And edgy.
Make it more progressively Like I keep on telling Ramesh ji also, Ramesh Turani I've did race with. You know, I said be a little more progressive about it, you know, and find a director and be ready to fail. Yeah. Rather than trying to play safe. And
to take the franchise forward.
To take the franchise forward.
I think the race thing is very exciting.
Yeah.
Because think about it, right? There's already a loyal fan base.
Correct.
So there are certain number of people that are going to be interested. So imagine if you give somebody like Abhinay, you know,
yeah.
who's a brilliant technician.
Yeah.
And very good with action. You've done 24 together.
Correct.
Something like that sort of a scale.
Correct, correct, correct.
And you know, you gave him a writer of his choice.
Yeah.
It could be very exciting. And actually, the opposite is that we end up taking risks
mm.
with new high concept films. Like we're taking a risk with Thar. So what we have to do is first we have to excite people about the world, educate them about the world, for them to come in and have that experience.
And then build the franchise.
So we're starting from scratch. But with Race, the fans already are there.
So what are the films you feel I should do? International films or directors I should work with in the future?
I really like the idea of On the Rocks, but you and Riya have dismissed me, rejected me.
I'm talking about myself.
Yeah, but for you only.
What is that?
On the Rocks is a comedy. Sofia Coppola's last film that she made for Apple Plus with Bill Murray. And it's a father-daughter. It's very funny.
Yeah.
I said, this is what happens now. I tell you, you don't remember that I've said, you don't listen. And then 2-3 years later, you remember that I told you. Broken Flowers.
Why are you mentioning films I've never heard about?
Because that's the point. No,
but tell me some films which I know.
No, so listen. So Broken Flowers is Bill Murray, again, when he was younger.
Yeah.
It's basically a road film. He goes to visit all of his ex-girlfriends. Very funny.
Yeah.
Something in that space, something lighter, but still with some nuance and depth.
So, how important is improvising in a scene as an actor, and do writers always appreciate that?
It depends on the film and depends on the director. Like I think Thar was quite designed. And you know, the writing was very specific and layered. So there wasn't really too much room for improvisation. But with Vasan's film or AK versus AK, you were there.
Yeah.
Full improvisation.
Yeah, of course. Like for example, when I worked with Javed Saab, when I did Mashal and I did Mr. India, I was very fortunate that, you know, with his writing and his dialogues and his script, you don't need to change
everything's
one
there.
Word. It's there. You know, any word, it's impossible to really make it better. Because Javed Saab also writes as an actor.
Yeah.
You know, he performs the scene and then writes it. And we were lucky that Raj and Anurag, I feel is today one of the best
yeah.
writers. And he
exactly.
not only That's helped what, us yeah. with the dialogues, but helped us in the edit also.
Can you tell if a movie is going to be good or bad while shooting? What is you get a gut feel?
Yeah, you know, obviously when you're doing a read a script, you like the script.
Yeah.
And you hope that what is there on the page
translates, yeah.
And sometimes you do that and the director somewhere falters when he's on the set. And sometimes the director is great. And then you do the film because the director is great.
Right.
And you feel he'll look after you, and somewhere you don't know that he's not really worked on the script as much as he should have, because he's so confident about his craft and the way he does his films.
Yeah.
And
the writing has been overlooked.
The writing has been overlooked. So then you come to know on the set that things are going wrong. And sometimes you come to know the film, things are going right in most of the places. But yaar koi acha ho raha hai, that you come to know.
Has it ever happened that you've managed to salvage a film in the edit with reshoot and it's a resounding success?
I wouldn't say about a great film, but became a good film like Beta. We almost shot the entire first half again.
That feeling now that you get, first day of the shoot, I was right, my instinct was correct, we're in trouble.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm so lucky, I've never had that feeling.
Yeah.
Yet.
Yeah.
I hope that I don't for a while, but...
No, but you will have to go through it.
Of course, no.
You will have to go through it.
Yeah.
You've been lucky now that you worked with the best filmmakers. Money has been spent, like Mirzia, Bhavesh Joshi, great directors. Then, uske baad you did with Vasan Bala. Netflix backed it. What we've done with Thar also.
Yeah.
That we've made, try to do a film which is as honest as it
possible,
can possible be. And I'm so happy that you believed in this. And you took the plunge, because you see what happens, a lot of actors become very conscious. You are, you know, I really enjoyed working with you and the entire team you
Fatima, introduced, everyone.
Introduced
yeah.
me to.
Yeah, yeah.
Like Raj Singh Chaudhary, Shriyaz, Priyanka, there's Mukti, Satish, there is Jitu. But still, you're a work in progress. There's a lot of improvement.
Yeah, of course.
A lot of things you have to improve as an actor, as a producer. This is what my honest feeling, and I want to
but
say this.
But even if you wanted to make Thar for theatres, I would have put my inheritance forward, signed the papers.
Yeah, but I don't know. I don't know.
No, I'm just joking.
I don't know. I know you're joking, but I feel, I think we got the right hope.
We got the right.
And hopefully, people also feel the same way. Didn't you feel nervous doing such a small cameo in AK
was very nervous. Very nervous.
I would have never done it.
Very
honestly.
I think the AK versus AK thing is honestly, creatively, was the scariest experience of my life. Because you know how Vikram is, man. Do it bad and chop
it off. So, especially if I'm there sitting on the edit, obviously.
Yeah, chop. Yeah. So this is a moment, an opportunity. You're part of a Vikram Aditya Motwani film again for the second time. So Vikram wrote a great scene and worked on that one scene with Jeff Goldberg for a month, yeah. Okay. And then it happened.
I just want to ask you, which is the film you really, what you have seen, Bollywood, Indian film industry, anywhere from India, which has blown your mind?
I like Miss Lovely by Osham. I like Udaan, Vikram's Udaan, I like a lot.
Okay.
Jonaki by Aditya Vikram Sen Gupta, who I've been begging you to meet. Vasan's first film, Mard.
Mard ko dard nahi hota.
I like it.
Yeah.
Vishal sir's early films.
Yeah.
Who else? I'm trying to think. I like Zoya's films, man.
Yeah.
Luck by Chance is good. Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara is a lot of fun. Dil Dhadakne Do is fun. Gully Boy is great.
What do you feel about AK versus AK?
AK versus AK, I love. I'm trying not to talk about the stuff that we've
done. Not your film, it's my film.
That we've done. Yeah.
What about Welcome?
No.
Come on, yeah.
I don't.
It's an iconic film, yeah. Majnu Bhai.
I don't really.
No?
Not my jam.
Come on, yeah. The whole world has loved it.
I know. And you'd be surprised, you know, like a lot of people that you think are like really indie and stuff also like. Everybody likes.
People, I'm telling you, I swear on God, all your favorite directors love the film.
It's one thing to watch and another thing to do.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I've gone to Chandan to watch Welcome.
Okay.
I've seen No Entry.
Yeah.
I've seen Singh is King.
Yeah.
So that's the thing is, I watch, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
I watch almost everything.
Correct.
But to actually do that stuff, I feel other people can do it better.
Yeah, better, yeah.
You know, so.
You need guts to do that.
Jaldhara aapke Thar mein. Pehli baar, 70 mm par.
Check out Thar. Now streaming on Netflix.